Hi, I'm Nate and you're watching Photolearningism. I thought it'd be fun to do a quickie comparison on using a drawing tablet, a really simple one by the way, in Krita and in GIMP, show you how to set them up, and leave you to your own conclusion so you can try that out. Let's do it! So once again, I'm Nate, this is Photolearningism. Thank you so much for joining in. If it's your first time here, thank you so much. I do a lot of work on this channel to surface the cheap or free art technologies so that you can know about them and make good use of them. Thank you for being here. So today, as I mentioned, I wanted to look at setting up and using a drawing tablet. And for reference, I am using the Huion H420. It is a very small tablet by comparison, but it's also very portable, very stable. The hardware consistently works. And there's a lot of great features with the pen and with the layout, a couple of quick access buttons that I want to jump through and just show you what it can do and also how it works with Krita and GIMP and offer some options that are really inexpensive. By the way, if you're interested in this this drawing pad at the end, I'm going to put a link in the description below that you can go check it out and consider purchasing it for yourself because it's very inexpensive and it's a good way to start if you're curious to start working on drawing tablets and figure out what's going to work for you. So back to where we were. All right, so I am actually going to begin by going into Krita here. This is actually a pre-alpha, by the way. In Krita's case, it was the current as of about less than a week ago for that release. This is the latest and greatest in terms of what they're building. It's not 100% stable, but it gives you some interesting insight into see what's coming. Going into the settings here, and again, that was under settings and then configure Krita. We're going to hop to the tablet settings here, and immediately you'll see some things. There's a pressure control, which you can either make that very high for hardness or low for softness, or just delete the point that you put in there if you don't like it at all. Default is right down the middle. That's where I'm going to leave it. You do have these two input options down here. I can't say that I found a terrible whole lot of difference with the two of them. You do have some advanced options here to kind of map sections of the screen, which is a cool idea. I played around with it a little bit in mapping to a custom area with the idea of, well, it'd be kind of neat if I could somehow map just the drawing space, but it kind of does some funny things where when you hit the point, the mouse just kind of jumps off and it changes pointers, and I don't know. It feels like they're still working on that one, perhaps, and that one has some interesting innovations, but has some room to grow. So for now, I would just say use information provided by the tablet, and that's been working out great. All right. I also enable this down here at the bottom, which is to use the mouse events for the right and left click buttons on the pen. I'll just jump over here quickly. There's two buttons, if you can see them there, the up and the down. That you can configure, at least in the case of the Huion tablet. You can set those to have what you want them to do. They offer some options built in, but I use it as the right click and the left click. And in Krita, you can use that like when you're working on layers, so I can quick access the menu and then use the left click to actually select something right from the pen. So that's very convenient. The pad itself has a few quick buttons, but those are more, again, generically. You could set mine are set to undo and to copy and to do just quick access things, and that's going to be on a per tablet basis. So, all right. So now that we have this on, we know it has already out of the box some built-in sensitivity, and some of these are brush specific. So you'll want to play around a little bit with the brushes themselves. You may need to go into the finer settings and refine them a little bit for hardness or whatnot. Just know that in Krita, those settings actually live with the brush. Outside the tablet settings that I just showed you. And right now it's getting different because I'm applying more pressure or less pressure, which causes the brush tip to either become more compressed virtually or backed away. It has less surface touch in that case. So that's how it works in Krita. And you could already see how there's some very interesting ways to use that, how you could finesse and draw very artistically, paying attention with pressure and also the boldness, the hardness, which is really cool. So that's Krita. Those are the basic settings there. let's hop over into GIMP. This one is a little more interesting and took a little bit more to figure out. So let me just start you off by saying that this is actually GIMP 2.10.20 for reference. I haven't gotten latest and greatest because I haven't seen features that compelled me to move forward yet. And I actually did try out the latest dev release, 2.99. I'm not going to remember the last piece of that, but within the last couple of days, and it actually didn't support the tablet. I think that's still being refined in the latest version. So don't try the dev version if you want to try the tablet. In this case, get a stable release for GIMP. So what we have to do is go under Edit and Preferences. You could also do Input Devices, but it's a little clearer to see going this way. And under Input Controllers, Input Devices, Configure Extended Input Devices, and then you'll see it detected my things. I found that I had to turn all of these one at a time. I had to hop in here and move it from disabled to screen. That seemed to bring them all, that seemed to unlock using this tool, and that's what did it for me. Save and close, and it was ready to go. So the next thing that really kind of mattered is, while that did allow me to draw and use the brushes here, it did not have any sensitivity to it. It didn't have any pressure or hardness control with these brushes. So under the dynamics, pencil generic, that will get you at least started because it already has some sensitivity built into the brush you're choosing. You can see that working. What kind of baffled me a little bit though is that you can't customize these dynamics. If I click the button here, it brings me here, but you'll notice I can't really do anything here. I can't change anything, can't make any adjustments. That was confusing. So I played around with it a little bit more, and I found that what you actually have to do is you have to create a copy of it. And to do that, you have to look at this one, the dynamics view of things. And if you right click one in particular, like this pencil generic, that works fairly well. You can either start a brand new one, or you can copy it. This is a little bit confusing. You want to duplicate it. That gives you a copy. That's how I ended up with pencil generic. And from there, I was able to make tweaks. If we were to select that one and then hop back in here to our options, we know how that's selected. Now, if I wanted to edit it, now you'll see that I can click on things and actually make some adjustments. So little caveat, little trickiness there, but it can get there. And once you do get there, then you can really unlock that same kind of power. You get the pressure and push sensitivity, and it becomes a lot more useful in that way. So that's that. All right. Again, I'm Nate. This is Photolearningism. I know this is kind of a shorter concept, and really I'm just trying to introduce this concept of how do you use tablet, how you extend the tools that we've already talked about so much. That's really what this is about. So again, if you're interested in this kind of tablet, I'll put a link in the description below if you want to go check it out some more on your own and get familiar with that product and consider buying it for yourself. Certainly no pressure, but it's there in case it helps you, because that's why I make these things. So consider giving me a thumbs up if this information was useful. Also consider subscribing so you don't miss out on the awesome projects we're going to get to in the future. And leave a comment, ask a question, join the community of learners, and be a part of something larger than ourselves. Thank you so much for spending so much time with me and spending some time learning a new technology. See you at the next video.